Good morning, one and all. I am A. Thangaraj, Assistant Professor of Triple E Department, GCE Bangalore. Today, we will discuss about block diagram reduction technique in control system. This is a very simple technique for any system like electrical, mechanical, or chemical system. We will see the rules of the block diagram reduction techniques. First, the simple rule. Rule one is combining the two cascade blocks. In block diagram, there are three elements. One is block, the second one is branch point, third one is summing point. Now see the first rule of block diagram reduction technique. The first rule is combining the two cascade blocks. This is normally the input is represented by R. This is reference input. The block is cascaded, block G1 and block G2. This is the output represented by C. In block diagram reduction technique, cascading the two blocks, this is equal to the multiplication of the two blocks G1, G2. The second rule is parallel the two blocks. The second rule, the input G1, G2, this is the summing point, whether it is adder or subtractor, depending upon the function, will the output. If the sign is positive, the output is G1 plus G2. Suppose the sign is negative, means here G1 minus G2. Now we will see the next rule. Third rule. This is the important rule in the block diagram reduction technique. Elimination of feedback loop. This is the input, summing point. This is the forward path G. This is the R. This is the negative feedback. The output is feedback by negative. The equivalent is, this is R. The simple block is G divided by G1 plus GH. Suppose the feedback is positive, here G divided by 1 minus GH. This is third rule. These are the main rules for simplifying the blocks. The fourth rule is The remaining four rules are there. The four rules are very important. The fourth rule is based on branch point. This is G. This is R. Here C. Here R. What is the value of here at the output? R into G. Because the gain R is multiplied with block G. C equal to R into G. But the here the output is R. The same output here is equivalent to, here the rule is the branch point after the moving the branch point after the block. Now R, this is G. What is the value here? What is the value should be here? C is equal to R into G. Is it correct? R into G. But here the one more constant is added because our answer must be R value. So here the output is G, G, not G, R into G, R into G into 1 by G. The output is, the final answer is R. That is, that's why we simply the shortcut rule I follow in our class. The branch point here, we write the letters in alphabetic order, branch point, summing point. Here, after the block, before the block. We remember only the first element of this value, 1 by G. The next is the inverse. This value, finally, G, 1 by G. The fifth rule is moving the branch point before the block. We should add the block. What is the value? Not 1 by G, this value G. Because we use the shortcut. The fifth rule. G here branch point. What is the value? R into G. Here also R into G. This is equivalent to, the branch point must be in front of the block G. Now we will check the output. C equal to R into G. Here also R into G. So these are equivalent values. Similarly, the other rules, O will be summing point before the block, after the block, U is the shortcut. Only we should remember this value only. In the block diagram reduction, the students are remember this value is enough for four rules in one table column. Now, next we will see one example for reduction of block using block diagram reduction technique. What is the value of C by R? This is our problem. Now we are using the, we have to obtain the C by R value using the block diagram reduction technique rules. Now first, we arrange the regular format or in a cascading form or parallel form or we should arrange in the form of elimination of feedback loop. Now, I use the using the one rule. Now, consider this block. This is the feedback loop, but there is some disturbance. Here H1 loop is in between the G2 and G3. So this branch point must be changed anywhere in the forward path. Now I shift the branch point after the block G3. Here I will shift. When I shift the branch point after the block, what is the value must be added? 1 by G. So, this is simplified into 1. We are going to move it to the next page. G1 G2 G3. This is H2. Here H1 by G3. This is the second step. The third step, we are consider these three blocks. This is like a this is a feedback. Here we are using the rule of feedback. We simply be the next. This is R. G1. Here we simplify using the feedback G divided by 1 by GH. Here G is G1, G2. Here one more rule is G1, G2, G3 divided by 1 plus G2, G3, H2. Here, the H1 is there. Feedback H1. H1 by G3. Now we are using the law of cascading, combining the cascading. G1, G2, G3 divided by 1 plus G2, G3, H2. Here H1 by G3. Finally, we simplify the two blocks using the elimination of feedback loop. G1, G2, G3 divided by 1 plus G1, G2, G3, H2 divided by 1 plus G1, G2, G3 divided by 1 plus G1, G2, G3, H2 into H1 by G3. Here it is cancelled. Now we simplify this value. The final answer is, this is R. This is C. G1, G2, G3 divided by 1 plus G1, G2, G3, H2 plus G1, G2, H1. This is the final answer. Thank you.